The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Happy morning, students. I know you all are doing good. You all must be busy because we are getting into the end of the academic year. So we have just two more chapters to go in our 10th standard chemistry syllabus. And I know you are able to understand, or if you find anywhere that you are uncomfortable, please do not hesitate, children. You can call me personally, or if I forget, please do remind me, because two, three of you have called. Because of the other issues, I may not be able to respond to you immediately. So do remind us again so that we will respond to you at the earliest. Okay, children. So now we are getting into our new topic. And there were some children who were asking me about the lab experiments. Definitely, children, once these chapters are over, I'll make sure that I'll take room for that, and I'll definitely do the experiment and show you in a separate video. Okay. So now today's class, we are going to begin with a new chapter, Nomenclature of Organic Compounds and Isomerism. When I say nomenclature, nomenclature means naming. You are going to name an organic compound. We are going to name an organic compound. And isomerism is the second part, which we'll be learning at the later classes. In this nomenclature, what are the important things that we should take into consideration? The first thing is importance of carbon. When I say organic compound, definitely it is going to be a primary element, that is carbon, which is forming a variety of compounds in the organic chemistry. Importance of carbon. So carbon being an element which is completely different when compared to other elements in the periodic table, because of its wonderful property, that is catenation. What is catenation? Carbon forming compounds with carbon. Carbon forming bonds with carbon again and again. Now that compound or that property, we call it as a catenation property. Carbon does not form compounds only with carbon, but also tries to form with other elements. It tries to form different type of bonds and different type of compounds also. So that branch of chemistry which deals with carbon and its compounds, we call it as organic chemistry. So in organic chemistry, we are going to study about carbon and its compounds. Now before getting into the nomenclature, let us learn the basics of carbon compounds. Now here you can see carbon I have put in three different ways. A single carbon with four single bonds. I have put a double carbon with two single bonds and one double bond. And here I have two carbons with a triple bond and one single bond. Now this is the skeletal structure of carbon compounds. Now we know carbon has got a valency of, what's the valency of carbon? Yes, it's in the 14th group, and the valency of carbon is 4. So if the valency of carbon is 4, and we know in the process of forming a chemical compound, we should make sure that the valency is satisfied. That is, carbon forming compounds with or joining bonds with other elements, the valency should be getting satisfied. So what happens here is the valency of carbon is 4. So in this skeletal structure, I am going to substitute all these single bonds with hydrogen. So I will see what is going to happen. Now let us do it together. Please write this skeletal structure in your notebook. So what happens here? Carbon, I have four single bonds. So I will substitute here hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. So this carbon having four single bonds is substituted with four hydrogen atoms. Now when I come to this carbon, carbon double bond, I have two double bond already. So the valency of carbon is 4. So now this carbon, I am going to put hydrogen here. Here also hydrogen, down one hydrogen and here one hydrogen. Let me see whether the valency is satisfied. So carbon here 1, 2, 3, 4. And for the second carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. So both the carbons are satisfied with the valency 4. Now we are going to look at the carbon-carbon triple bond. So what happens here? I have a single bond here, I'll substitute with hydrogen, and here also I'm substituting it with hydrogen. Now let me check the valency. So carbon here 1, 2, 3, 4. So valency is satisfied. And for this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. And here also the valency gets satisfied. Now let me write these structures here and I'll write the molecular formula. So now here we are going to learn how to write the molecular formula. Now let me write this carbon, hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. So what is the molecular formula here? C is there and hydrogen is there. In carbon only one carbon, but hydrogen I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So I put here CH4. Understood? So now here what I will do? I have to write it as carbon, double bond, carbon. I have here hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. So here I will write carbon. How many carbon atoms? 2. So C2 and hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4. C2H4. Understood, children? Similarly, for this, how we will write? I have C2, two carbon atoms, but hydrogen I have only 2 again. So C2H2, that is the third one. So with this, we have written the structure of the compound and the molecular formula. You have here in your textbook written structure of the compound and its molecular formula. See, now we will be learning about the characteristics of the compound in the table. What do you mean by characteristic features, properties? First one is they are hydrocarbons. Do you agree, children? Yes, they are hydrocarbons because it is completely made up of hydrogen and carbon. So these are called as hydrocarbons. There are the compounds having single bond, double bond and triple bond between the carbon atoms. So you have carbon with single bond, carbon with double bond and carbon with triple bond. So these are hydrocarbons and you have single, double and triple bond. Now the structure of this compound can be written in a condensed way. What do you mean by condensed way? Condensed way means writing in a short form. So now here I am going to tell you how we can write it in a short way. Like for example, if you take C, valency of carbon is 4. So carbon 1, 2, 3, 4 and this carbon also 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if I am going to substitute with hydrogen, I have 3 hydrogens here, 3 hydrogens here. Now what is the molecular formula? Carbon here will be C2 and hydrogen I have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, C2H6. Now this is the structural formula and this is my molecular formula. There is a formula which is called as condensed formula. What is condensed formula? I'll write here CH3. This is called as condensed formula. Carbon, 3 hydrogens I have written here. This is my carbon with 3 hydrogen. And here also carbon with 3 hydrogens I have written here. So this we call it as condensed formula. You understood? I'll give you one more example where you can understand a little bit better. So let's take with three carbon atoms, one single bond carbon, single bond carbon. Now I know this is my single bonded carbon. Valency of carbon is 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And for this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. And for my second carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what is my next step? I need to substitute this with hydrogen atoms. So I put hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Everywhere I substitute with hydrogen. Now what will be my molecular formula? I have how many carbon atoms? I have 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms. So I put C3. And hydrogen I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So C3H8. Now how do I represent my condensed formula? First I will write this part. CH3. I put a single bond. CH2. I put again a single bond, then I'll write my last part CH3. So this we call it as a condensed formula. What is condensed? The expanded one is written in the condensed form. That we call it as a condensed formula. So this is my structural formula, this is my molecular formula, and this is my condensed formula. So that is called as condensed formula. Now the open chain hydrocarbons, this is my open chain hydrocarbon where the carbon atoms have only single bond. You can see only single bond in the open chain hydrocarbon. You call them as alkanes. What do you call them as? Alkanes. Alk, you should remember, anes, the hydrocarbon which has only single bond in its structure. In a chemical compound, carbon bonding with hydrogen, if the bonds present in the compound is only a single bond, then you name it as alkanes. They are called as alkanes. Alkanes, all the four valency of carbon is satisfied by single bond. Do you agree with me, children? All the valency is satisfied only by single bond, and such a compound we call it as saturated hydrocarbon. See, we are learning so many different terms. So please understand, children, this is an open chain structural formula where all the bonds are single bond. When all the bonds are single bond in an open chain hydrocarbon, you call them as alkanes. And if all the valency of carbon is satisfied by single bond, you call them as saturated hydrocarbon. So what are saturated hydrocarbon? Saturated hydrocarbons are compounds where the valency of carbon are satisfied only by the single bond, and you call them as alkanes. I hope you understood this, children. It is given in your textbook very clearly. Okay, now you can take page number 98. We have an exercise for us to do. Let us do that now. Okay, you have your textbook with you now. Now in the textbook, the first one, complete the given table below. First one is number of carbon atoms, structure of alkanes, condensed formula and molecular formula. The first three are already given, which I have written. The fourth question is structure of alkanes. Number of carbon atoms are 4. Number of carbon atoms are 4. So I'll put here 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms. Right? I should write the structure of the alkane. So I told you, when an organic compound has only single bond between the carbon atoms, put single bond everywhere to satisfy the valency of carbon. Each carbon should have 4 bonds surrounding it. So every carbon is having 4 single bonds surrounding it. Now what should I do? I should write the structure. How to write the structure? I should fill all my single bonds with hydrogen. So let me start filling hydrogens everywhere. So once I start filling hydrogens, I got a structure like this. Now fourth, next what is given? Condensed formula. What is condensed formula? CH3. I have written CH3, single bond, CH2. So I put here CH2, again single bond, CH2. So I put CH2, again single bond, CH3. So I put CH3. This is my condensed formula. Once writing condensed formula, I should write the molecular formula. Now with this, it is easy for me to write the molecular formula. So how will I write now here? 1, 2, 3, 4. C4. 4 carbon atoms. And how many hydrogen atoms? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. C4H10. So right, we have C4H10. Now last one is a homework for you. You can do it and you should write it in the file when you're coming to school. You must show me that. Okay. The last one, C5H12, which is pentane. Okay. Now we will be solving some questions that are given in the textbook about alkanes. Okay. What is the relationship between number of atoms of carbon and hydrogen in alkane? So let us take an example here. C3H8. This is an example of a molecular formula of an alkane. What is the first question they have asked? What is the relationship between number of atoms of carbon and hydrogen in alkane? Relationship between carbon and hydrogen in alkane. If carbon is 3, hydrogen will be 3 into 2 plus 2. Am I right? 3 into 2 is 6 plus 2, which is 8. So if carbon is 3, this is 3 into 2 plus 2. That is, if carbon is N, hydrogen will be N into 2 plus 2. Am I right, children? This is the relation. Twice the carbon atoms plus 2 added to it. That is the number of hydrogen atoms in an alkane. So you write there the relationship between number of atoms of carbon and hydrogen. Please write there. Twice the number of carbon atom plus 2 added to it. Please write. Are you all writing, children? Twice the number of carbon atoms plus 2 added to it. So the second question is, if an alkane contains n carbon atoms, if an alkane contains n carbon atoms, how many hydrogen atoms will be there? So hydrogen will be 2 into n plus 2. How much will be the hydrogen? 2 into n plus 2 will be the number of hydrogen atoms. So can you deduce the molecular formula? So what will be the general formula for alkanes? For alkanes, the general formula will be, so please write, alkanes, general formula is CnH2n plus 2. Remember, this is the general formula for alkane, CnH2n plus 2. Have you written, children? Yes. Now they have given us two molecular formula. One is CH4 and C2H6. CH4, C2H6. What is the difference between the number of carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms in CH4 and C2H6? What is the difference? Here you have 2, here you have 1. So difference of carbon is 1. Hydrogen 4, hydrogen 6. So difference will be 6 minus 4. So the difference between these two is 1 carbon and 2 hydrogen. Now let us take one more example. What is the difference between C2H6 and C3H8? These two carbon atoms, compounds, it is again C2C3. 3 minus 2, 1 carbon atom. And here 8 minus 6, 2 carbon atoms. So the difference is again CH2. Is the difference same in the case of every successive compound? So what is the difference between the molecular formula of any two successive alkanes. Please write there CH2. Please write, children, CH2. Now, a series of such compounds is called as homologous series. CH4, C2H6, C3H8, C4H10, C5H12. In all these cases, the difference will be CH2. Such a series where the difference is the same, you call them as homologous series. Homo means, you know, same, similar. So you have similar difference between successive organic compounds, you call it as homologous series. Now let us learn the characteristics of homologous series. The members can be represented by a general formula. What is the general formula for all these members of alkane groups? Remember, children, CnH2n+2. So these members of the group can be represented by a general molecular formula. Successive members differ by CH2. What do you mean by successive member? This is my first member. The second one is the successive member of the first one. So difference between these two is CH2. Again, once the second is reached, the difference between third and second is again CH2. The difference between the fourth and third is again CH2. So CH2 is the difference between each of the successive members in the same homologous series. Members show similarity in chemical property. See, we all belong to the same family. So we do possess similar characteristic features. Like we say, when you come from the same family, you all will be having the same characteristic features. You'll be having the same properties. Similarly here, the members of the same group will show same properties. There is a regular gradation in their physical properties. Regular gradation means regular increase. As the number of carbon atoms and hydrogen atom increases, the properties, physical property also increases. What are physical properties? Their weight, their melting point, boiling point, all these comes under physical properties. So I hope you are able to understand what is homologous series and what is the characteristics of the homologous series. Now we have learnt about alkanes. I told you alkanes are saturated hydrocarbons where the organic compound have only single bond present in it, and each of the valency of carbon is satisfied only by single bond. You call them as saturated hydrocarbon. Now we are going to learn a new type of hydrocarbon which we call it as unsaturated hydrocarbon. What do you mean by unsaturated? In saturated, there were only single bond present in the hydrocarbon, but here we have double bonds present in the hydrocarbon. Not only double bonds, it can be double or it can be triple. So when we are drawing the structures of carbon, I showed you carbon with single bond, carbon with double bond, and carbon with triple bond. So when carbon are surrounded only by single bonds, you call them as saturated hydrocarbon. When you have carbon surrounded by double bond and triple bond, you call it as unsaturated hydrocarbons. So hydrocarbons having double bond or triple bond between the carbon atoms, you call them as unsaturated hydrocarbons. And when it has only double bond, you call them as alkenes. Remember, children, with single bond you were naming it as alkanes. Anes were used. So this alk will remain the same. If it is single bond, it is anes. If it is double bond, it is called as enes, alkenes. Okay. So hydrocarbons having double bond between any two carbon atom, you call them as alkenes. Now again, here we have question given, complete the table. Let us see how much we can do it. So one I'll do it for you, the one will be a homework. So we have the second and third. Second one is C double bond C with four hydrogens, and so I can write it as CH2 double bond CH2 which is the molecular formula C2H4. Next one is carbon double bond, carbon single bond. It is not necessary that everywhere it should be double bond. Valency will not get satisfied. So three carbon atoms will have a double bond either here or either here. Now satisfy the valency of hydrogen. Okay, so you get here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what you will do here, here there will be no hydrogen. This carbon is having 1, 2, 3, 4, and now this carbon will have 1, 2, 3, 4. So this will be the open structure. How do I write the condensed one? First let me write this. It is CH2. Please listen carefully, children. I have a double bond, so I put a double bond. Now I have here the second set, which is only CH. So I put CH. Now this part is over. I put a single bond. Now what do I have here? CH3. So I put here CH3. Right? This is the condensed formula where the valency is satisfied. Double bond will be only in one position. Anywhere in the compound, if you see a double bond, it is an alkene. Now I will write the molecular formula. C3, 3 carbon atoms, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, C3H6. Understood? Next one is C4. So now I should put 4 carbon atoms. How will I put? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I can put double bond wherever I want. I can put it here, I can put it here, or I can put here also. So let me put it in the center. So I have carbon here, 1 carbon atom. Valency of carbon is 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I put my hydrogens. Understood? So now this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3. So fourth carbon, I put a hydrogen. And this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3. Fourth, I put a hydrogen atom. And here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Everywhere I put hydrogens. Children, you are able to understand me, right? So now I will write the condensed formula. See, the first part I write this. So I put here CH3, single bond, C, this is my CH. So I put CH, then I have a double bond here. I put double bond, again CH, the third part. I put a single bond and the last one is CH3. This is my condensed formula. Now what should I do in the next step? I should write the molecular formula. So here C4, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. C4H8. If you see the difference here, it is C2H4, C3H6, C4H8. 2 into 2, 4. 3 into 2, 6. 4 into 2, 8. So what will be the molecular formula here? If carbon is N, hydrogen is 2N. 2 into the number of carbon atoms. That will be the molecular formula for alkenes. These are alkenes. We are studying about alkenes now. Right. So the last one is a homework for you. Again, which you will be doing and submit, bringing it on the day when you are coming here. So general formula, the next page, in page 100, they have asked the general formula. It is CnH2n. Right, with that, I will stop, children. Okay, if possible, I'll try to give some homework with your class teachers along with the broadcast group so that you can work it out and send it to me. Okay, children. So with this, we'll stop off alkanes and alkenes. The next class, we will learn about alkynes and its naming of the organic compounds. When you're writing this, you should learn it very seriously. Wherever, whatever is important, the most important thing which you should remember is valency of carbon should be satisfied. Carbon should have 4 bonds surrounding it. It can be 2 here, 1 on the top, 1 at the bottom, or it can be 2 on left or 2 on right. It depends on how you deduce the formula. Is that clear, children? If you have any doubt, don't hesitate. Try to do the questions that are given in the textbook. Copy the things which are necessary in the file, because this lesson, especially organic chemistry, When you are drawing the chemical compounds, it is most important that you write and practice. The more you write and practice, you will get thorough with writing the molecular formula. Because we may be correct in writing the structural formula, but when we are writing the condensed formula or the molecular formula, we may end up with errors. We may make mistakes. So make sure that you don't make simple mistakes when you are doing such chemical formula, because these are very, very, very important. Definitely, I'll make sure that I'll jot down few questions for you for practice so that you can learn more better. Right? So copy the things in the file which are necessary, go through it. If you find anything that you don't understand, when you're coming to school for the file correction, definitely you have the right to ask to the teacher, clarify your doubts before proceeding to the next topic. Is that clear, children? Hope you enjoy the class today, and see you in the next class. Until then, stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.